Hi, this is Shashanand. Welcome to Aerotech Solutions. Let's see the application with microcontroller, square wave generation using microcontroller. So this application contains three units as power supply and microcontroller. And to test your square wave output, you need to use digital oscilloscope. There is power supply unit. It uses to convert your AC source into DC, which is used for microcontroller. So DC source, how to convert your AC to DC using three individual sections as bridge rectifier, filter and regulator. Bridge rectifier converts your AC to pulsating DC, but this is not pure DC. So you need to filter the ripples from converted DC. The ripples which are filtered through electrolytic capacitors. Electrolytic capacitors allows AC and blocks DC. The block DC which passes through regulators, and regulator, it gives constant output irrespective of any input. So the regulator series is 78XX. So now in this application you need to use 7805 to provide 5 volts output, whereas microcontroller, so here I am using 8051 microcontroller to generate a square wave. So microcontrollers support different features as RAM, ROM, IO ports, timers, counters, interrupts and serial port. In this application, I am using timers concept to generate time delays for square wave. So you can use any IO pin to generate your square wave. So you have to manage it with logic high and low with proper time delays. So let's see how to generate time delays by using timers. So you know that timers are used to generate accurate time delays. So how timers are giving accurate time delays? Just by counting pulses. So based on the capacity of timer, timer can able to count number of pulses based on the capacity. If timer supports 16 bit, then it can count 2 power 16 pulses for one complete cycle, as comparison as with your regular clock. How your time regular watch is giving time for us? Just by counting seconds and by counting minutes, by counting hours. The same way, to count, to get your required time delay, you need to go with this counting process. But for each count, there is a fixed time delay from your timers. This based on crystal oscillator frequency, whatever you are connecting from hardware. So mostly 8051 families works with 12 MHz. Each pulse, which means each count duration is very clear. For that formula is pulse period is equal to 12 divided by crystal frequency. If you are working with 12 MHz, the pulse duration is 1 microsecond. If you are working with other frequencies like 24 MHz, time duration is 0.5 seconds. If you are increasing your frequency, then pulse period will decrease. Based on your required time delay, you need to calculate how many pulses you need to count. Like to get your 1 minute time, you need to count 60 seconds. For 2 minutes time, 120 seconds. For 3 minutes time, 180 seconds. So but timer for one complete rotation, you will get only 160 seconds from regular clock. Whereas the same concept you are using from timers, by counting 65,536 pulses, you will get 65,536 microseconds time. If you are working with 12 MHz. So based on that, you need to calculate number of pulses. How many pulses you need to count to get your required time delay. For number of pulses, formula is very clear, required time delay divided by pulse period. Now I am looking for 1 second time delay, whereas on time period for your pulse period, 1 second, off time period is 1 second. So 1 second divided by 1 microsecond, so that you will get 1 crore pulses. So, but timer can count only 65,536 pulses for one rotation. If you are looking for this number of pulses, you should go with this multiplication combination. So, which is 50,000 into 20 times. Whereas timer can count only 0 to 65,535. So that to count this one tour pulses, you need to count this 50,000 into 20. Sorry, which is 10 lakhs pulses. So to count this 10 lakhs pulses, you need to go with this multiplication combination 50,000 into 20. So but to count these 50,000 pulses, you cannot start with 0. But timer can stop at only by reaching maximum value. You don't have any chance to stop your timer at any middle point. If you start with 0, there is no chance it stop at 50,000. So that you have to find out initial value. So initial value, what I am doing, I am subtracting this 50,000 from maximum value, 65,535. So I will start from 15,535. If you start from 15,535 and you count up to 65,535, you counted 50,000 pulses. So this process I'll repeat 20 times so that I'll count 10 lakhs pulses. So these values you need to load with this SFR registers TH and TL from timer. The timer related SFR registers are TMOD, TCON, TH1, TL1, TH0, TL0. So these registers you are going to use in program. So this is a simple circuit. So I am just connecting I/O pin P2.0 with the digital oscilloscope. I can show you output with logic analyzer and simulation tool. Let's see the source code of this application, which is square wave generation, which is already developed in Keil Microvision. Keil Microvision IDE supports to develop all embedded C programs for all different microcontrollers from different manufacturers. So let's see the first line of this program, hash include reg51.h. So this allows to use all SFR register names related to 51 families without any declaration. So I am just using this user defined declaration, which is wave. I just given connection across P2.0 pin. And I am taking one user defined function, which is delay and main. This logic starts from main. Initial logic is 0 and while of 1. And I am giving logic 1 for this wave input. The next function I am calling delay. So let's see this timer related steps in this delay function. So this TMOD is equal to 0x10. This value decides timer 1 mode 1. So that you can use your timer 1 with 16 bit mode. In 16 bit mode, it can count 0 to 65,535 pulses. And the initial values, which is already calculated from presentation. So these 3CAF I am using here to assign the initial values for your registers. Higher byte with TH1 and lower byte value with TL1. And TR1 is equal to 1. This is for start the timer. And these two are initial values of timer 1. And whenever timer reaches maximum value, so which means whenever timer starts from 3CAF to FFFF, which means 65,535. So whenever timer reaches maximum value, flag bit becomes 1. So you need to wait until flag bit becomes 1. So while of TF1 equals to 0, terminates with semicolon means If it remains 0, stay here. Whenever it becomes 1, then come to the next line. Clear this flag bit, because you have to repeat this process 20 times. So clear this flag bit and reassign the values for your TH and TL registers and wait for 1. So this process will run 20 times because I am looking for 10 lakhs pulses. After completion of 10 lakhs pulses counting, then you can stop your timer and come back to main program. After delay, then again wave is equal to 0. So that you are keeping your IO pin high and 1 second time on and 0 1 second time off. So you can observe from oscilloscope square wave. So I will show you this output with debug session. To check the output of this program, you can enter into debug session. Further, go debug tab and use the option start or stop debug session. And you can open your logic analyzer window from view tab, view and analysis window. This is your logic analyzer. And here you need to set up your IO pin. Which IO pin you are trying to do? P2.0. Enter. Now you can run your output. Go debug tab and use run option. So this will show you the square wave. So you need to fix your oscillator frequency. That's also very important from this. You can watch your on time period. So starts from 0.0 seconds to, this is up to 1 second. And even your off time ends with 2.0. And off time ends with 3. So like this, you can cross check your output by using analyzer window. So let's show you this application output with simulation tool, which is Proteus. So this is one popular simulation tool which helps to check all hardware results with the help of software. So this program you need to link with your microcontroller, but it allows .hex file. So this will show you waveform on this digital oscilloscope. So this is a way to test your oscilloscope square wave generation output with digital oscilloscope in simulation. If you want to get your output with real hardware, simply you can connect your oscilloscope channel with P2.0 pin from hardware. So for more videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube, Aerotech Solutions. Please give your valuable feedback as comment and like and share. If anyone is looking for embedded system training, please get back with this number 9676327118. Even you are delivering placement services and you are into development also, and you will do all kinds of projects with all different microcontrollers, including OS and non-OS applications. If you want to reach our office, please go with this address. You are located in Kukatpally Housing Board near Metro Station. And any queries, please write an email us ysnanda@eretechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.